Okay, so I don't look at the camera, I look at you. Okay.
Hello, my name is Julia van Straaten and I'm a junior programmer at the Chinese Room. I started my career actually as a software developer or engineer. I did a bachelor's in the Netherlands. It was like 4 years, and during those 4 years I at some point realized that it wasn't really for me, and because of that I had to pick a new package of like courses, and I ended up picking the game design one. I started like my summer when I was finally finished just applying for different jobs, and the Chinese Room accepted me, so there you go. I mean, when I was learning programming, and this is a bit of a boring answer maybe, my most useful resource was Google. Looking up just small questions and then answers. There are a plethora of different forums out there that are all very useful. We use Unreal Engine, so I'm on the Unreal Engine forums all the time. So using Google to get to that is very useful, but also directly going to the forums is very useful. So in a game, you have like a lot of non-player characters walking around, right? But all of these non-player characters still have some kind of program that they need to run. My job involves setting such things up, just making everything come to life essentially. So it's not just a dull game where you can only do, I guess, just walking around and nothing else, no interaction, nothing. For a programmer, I think like the daily structure is like more or less the same every day. In the morning, for me it's at 10, we have a stand-up meeting where we just have like our team coming together, and we just discuss what we've done the previous day and what we're gonna do today. And then from that point onwards, yeah, I just more or less get started, I guess. I'll just pick a task then and start working on that. Often there's also bug fixing, so I'll be contacted by someone from QA asking me to fix something, which often takes priority. So I think one of the things that some people might not really know about programming is that sometimes you can really get very, very stuck on something, and then it just turns out to be a little check mark that's missing somewhere, or a little spelling mistake that you made, and then everything just breaks because of that. So it can be quite painful sometimes, but it's also fun once you find the mistake. I really enjoy working at the Chinese Room because I already felt like there was a great sense of community, but once I started coming here, which is so nice to be able to tap someone on the shoulder and just ask them a quick question, or sometimes we just discuss some games that we've been playing on the weekend, and it's been really great to see how well everyone gets along, and it's been really great.